I thought I'd get a break from the whole isekai thing, but here we are again. Five anime like Bofuri. Can you guess what waifus these are? Let's kick this list off with a completely unique concept. Number 1. Didn't I say to make my abilities average in the next life? Okay, so get this. A normal human girl dies and goes to heaven, just to find out that she is going to be reincarnated into a fantasy world.
Are you an idiot?
Wait, you've watched an anime like this before? Damn. Well, before being reincarnated, Miss Protagonist has the opportunity to have any one wish granted. She is tired of being popular, so she wishes to be completely and utterly average in her next life. Well, it turns out that the god in this story took the word average as meaning average among all life forms, not just humans. So our protagonist is reborn as Adelaide von Aschum, and she contains an unbelievable amount of magic power. Adelaide leaves her home and attends a school for hunters, and she tries her best to live a completely normal life. Spoiler alert, that doesn't happen. This anime is like Bofuri for a handful of reasons. To start off with, both anime have stupidly long titles. Next, both anime revolve around an overpowered cute girl who spends her days doing cute girl things. Then both of these shows are dumb and funny isekai anime, and they both give off a very similar vibe. Yes, I know Bofuri technically isn't an isekai, but it's the same idea. Personally, I'm not a big fan of this anime if I'm being honest. It's definitely not a bad show, but the plot and characters just didn't really appeal to me. I really wish I could talk about a series called Only Sense Online, but sadly, it doesn't have an anime yet. Number 4, Wise Man's Grandchild. This anime also has a super unique concept. Okay, follow me this time. A normal human dies, only to find out that he's going to be reincarnated into a fantasy world.
Yep, he's an idiot.
Oh, yeah, that is the same as before. Let's see, the protagonist is blatantly overpowered. He attends high school, he makes a bunch of friends and defeats some bad guys. Aha! I found the difference. In this anime, our protagonist Shin doesn't know how to socialize with others. Look, after all these isekai-focused videos, I'm starting to run out of video game and isekai anime to talk about. But this anime does have some minor similarities to Bofuri. For example, both protagonists act awkward and out of place for the situations they find themselves in. Shin doesn't know how to be a quote-unquote normal teenager, while Maple doesn't know how to play a video game like a quote-unquote normal player. Another similarity would be how Shin and Maple are both constantly recruiting new allies as the story progresses. Just like the first entry, this anime is not my type of show, but if you enjoy generic power fantasy anime, then by all means go check out Wise Man's Grandchild. Have you ever dreamt of playing a VR MMO similar to Call of Duty or Battlefield? I know you have, so be sure to pay attention here. Number 3, Sword Art Online Alternative, Gun Gale Online. This is a spin-off series which follows completely separate characters and story than regular SAO. Gun Gale Online is a VR MMO where the players use all types of guns and explosives to battle monsters and sometimes other players. This anime follows a woman named Karen who uses the virtual world of Gun Gale Online as a much-needed escape from her everyday life. I think we can all relate to that. In-game, she goes by the name of Lin, but she is more commonly known as the infamous player killer, Pink Devil. After befriending a very skilled but odd player named Pitoi, Lin decides to enter Squad Jam, which is a team-oriented battle royale. The kicker is that Lin and Pitoi are not on the same team. SAO Alternative is like Bofuri for two major reasons. First off, both anime follow a cute girl who starts off as a complete newbie with little to no idea how to play the game. Then both anime take place primarily inside of a VR MMO where massive multiplayer tournaments are a large focus of the game. Look, if you enjoy Bofuri, then chances are you're going to love watching this tiny pink girl mow down hordes of players using a pink P90, which she has appropriately nicknamed P-chan. If you are enjoying this video or find it useful, be sure to like and subscribe for more recommendations in the future. Number 4, Infinite Dendrogram. Our protagonist is a young man named Riji, and he recently purchased the VR MMO Infinite Dendrogram. Infinite Dendrogram has the amazing ability to stimulate all five human senses, and is so advanced that the NPCs think entirely for themselves and are almost indistinguishable from the players. With the help of his older brother Shu and his partner Nemesis, Reiji begins exploring the quite literal infinite number of possibilities that Infinite Dendrogram has to offer. Infinite Dendrogram is like Beaufree due to the setting and the comedy. Obviously, both anime take place inside a VR MMO fantasy world, then neither show takes itself too seriously. Both anime are well aware that they are obnoxiously dumb and funny, and this is the perfect type of anime to watch if you just want to turn your brain off and relax. Let me know in the comments, is there actually anyone out there who hasn't watched this anime yet? Number 5, The Rising of the Shield Hero. Naofumi Iwatani lives at home with his parents and is your normal run-of-the-mill otaku. While reading a book at the library, Naofumi is magically transported into another world to be the legendary shield hero. Shortly after arriving in this world, he winds up being framed for a crime that he didn't commit by this bitch. Okay, nobody get offended, there's an inside joke hidden there. Anyways, after having everything taken from him, Naofumi must struggle to level up and survive if he wants to make it back to his own world. Shield Hero's likeness to Beaufree is very much just on the surface. Naofumi uses a shield as his weapon just like Maple. Then both anime have a video game type of setting. The actual plot and story of Shield Hero is completely different from Beaufree. But if you look at the stats and ratings, chances are you're going to love this anime. Were you able to guess what waifus these are? It's Rim and Ram from ReZero. If you would be interested in some gorgeous looking anime artwork, be sure to check out my poster review linked in the card above. My name is Unseen Whispers, and did you know I have a Discord server? If you would like to join, link is in the description. Anyways, thanks for watching, I hope to see you next time.